Everybody, Gina DeLuca here. I know it's been a long time. It's been a month since I've done a painting. We have been going nuts with our landscaping project, which just seems to keep getting bigger because I keep getting more ideas, much to my boo's chagrin. But it's looking amazing out there. We're in the process of creating a monarch sanctuary in our backyard, and we've had to remove 8 trees. 2 of them needed to be done professionally. It has been a lot of work, a lot of work. But if anybody's interested, just leave a comment and I will do a little video of what we've done. And otherwise, I won't bore you guys with that stuff. Today, we will be doing, I'm gonna do a straight pour. I have the Arteza, these are the iridescent acrylic paints. These are matte and finish. So I'm going to be seeing what happens in a straight pour. Will they sell? Not sure. This is the color I'll be using for my background. It's also Arteza. Pearl Glacier Blue is the color. And I've never actually tried a straight pour with a metallic as the background. So we're experimenting today. At the very least, the colors are pretty. So that should work out. The other colors I'm using are Electric Plum Purple, which is really pretty in the cup. I don't know if you're going to be able to see how cool that looks, but it's like the blue flash in that plum color. We have Glowing Peach and Playful Pink. This is pretty sheer when it dries, so I don't expect it to create a lot of difference color-wise, but it might create a cool effect when it's blended in. So we'll see what happens with that. I have some titanium white here that I'll just be using as a base coat. I have noticed when I use metallics as a base coat that the paints don't want to glide as smoothly over it, probably because of the mica. So I just opted for traditional titanium white. Before we get started, I need to show you my Fluid Art Inspiration cards. If you've already seen this bit, you can just fast forward to the painting. If you've not seen it, what it is. There are 52 cards in this deck. They're tarot size, so they're nice and big. And 42 of those cards are technique cards, like this one. There's an associated video that will give you the tutorial. And there's a little box that contains a tip. There's a color palette associated with that particular painting. And then these two boxes are meant to be used together as a two-color pour. Just as an idea for a two-color pour, or you can add another color to it. And there are also 8 bonus palette cards, each one having 5 different palettes. Use all the colors, use some of the colors. And they are also helpful, not just for painting, but whatever artistic projects you may be doing. Whether it's beadwork or stained glass or what have you. They are available at my website, ginadeluca.net. Okay, now for the fun stuff. These paints have been mixed with Floetrol as my pouring medium. These bottles, I did a 1-to-1 ratio. This stuff is very rich, so I did 2 parts Floetrol to 1 part paint. And then those are thinned to the proper consistency, with my concoction of 90% water and 10% Floetrol. The consistency would be a 1 on my consistency scale. You can see it just disappears immediately into the paint. And this does contain mica, so things with mica are, they appear thicker than they are. It takes some practice to get the proper consistency when you're dealing with metallics. They can be tricky. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is lay down our base coat. Okay, my base coat is down. And now I'm going to put some paint in the cup. This is a 12 by 12 canvas. I'm going to put 5 ounces in my pouring cup. And for this sheer color, there is of course no silicone in here, no silicone in a straight pour for me. Well, that's what makes it a straight pour, just paint. Well, paint and pouring medium, but no additives. Also, what makes it a straight pour for me is that you just pour it straight. Let's see what happens. I'm gonna come up from up high so it has a chance to churn a bit. As I get close to the end of the cup, I get closer to the canvas to keep my center nice and tight. Okay, generated lots of air bubbles. So let's pop those with our handy torch. All right, let's give this a tilt and see what happens. I'll start in this corner. Remember to bring your paint back to center before changing directions. The weight of your paint will be easy to see because that's where it's going to be moving the fastest. So you want to be able to control that. I'll be very interested to see what this looks like once it's dried and varnished. But there's some very pretty lacing going on. All right, I will clean up and I'll bring you in for a close-up. Back in a few.
Okay, here it is. This is dried, actually. The metallic paint as the background gave a very interesting effect. It's like this. It's a very 3D effect. That is genuine 3D. There was schmutz and I missed it. Very, very naughty of me. It's a shame this isn't really picking up the shimmer the way I'm seeing it with my eyeballs. But it has a very, the whole thing just has a very pretty sheen to it. It looks different from every angle. So there you have it. That's what happens when you use an Arteza Metallic as your background in a street pour. There it is. If you enjoyed this video, if you learned something, please do feel free to check out the Venmo and PayPal tip jar. Another great way to support this channel is to check out my Amazon store. Lots of the products that I use in my videos are available in that store. And anything that you purchase off the entire site of Amazon, if you enter through that link, I receive a small commission of at no additional cost to you. Pennies turn into dollars, you know what I'm saying? So if you're shopping there anyway, it's greatly appreciated. My website, ginadeluca.net, to get the fluid art inspiration cards, my paintings, or my music. I do have some CDs for sale. And yeah. Join our group. Go make some art. Post your masterpieces. Ask your questions. Get some inspiration. All that good stuff. All right, y'all. If you made it this far, thumbs up to you. And I hope y'all have a beautiful day. Now go make some art.